All right, good afternoon, and welcome to the Illinois Tollway's Diversity Webinar Series. My name is Alexander Karahalios, and I am the Business Analyst for the Department of Diversity and Strategic Development. If this is your first Illinois Tollway sponsored webinar, welcome and thank you for joining us. If you have attended in the past, welcome back. The Illinois Tollway's DBE program is recognized nationally as a leader in removing barriers and creating additional access to economic opportunities for historically underrepresented companies and people. After more than a decade of commitment to leveling the playing field in construction, professional services, goods and services, and workforce development, and more than $2.7 billion committed to disadvantaged firms, we can confidently say that more small, diverse, women and veteran-owned firms are doing business with the Tollway than ever before. In 2020, the Tollway created a webinar series to stay in contact with the DBE and small business community. Since then, more than 5,000 people have learned how to do business with the Tollway, get certified with the state, or prepare a better statement of interest submittal. At any time, you can access our webinars on the Tollway's website. There you will discover our library of more than 90 webinars presented over the past 3+ years. While things have changed since 2020, the goal of the Diversity Webinar Series remains the same, and that is to present you with various topics that will help you be a successful business and pursue Tollway work. Now, before we get started, let's go over a few housekeeping rules that will help ensure a more enjoyable experience for everyone with us today. All of our attendees will be muted. If you do have any questions, please enter them in the chat box and they will be answered during the Q&A portion of the webinar. If you happen to miss something or want to review this presentation, again, these webinars are recorded and posted on the Illinois Tollway's diversity page. Today's webinar topic is Illinois Department of Transportation Disadvantaged Business Enterprise, or DBE certification. Joining us today is DBE certification unit manager Lincoln Blackwell from the Illinois Department of Transportation's Bureau of Small Business Enterprises. At this time, I will turn the presentation over to Lincoln.
Good afternoon. As stated, my name is Lincoln Blackwell. I've been doing certification for right around 20 years, 15 years with the Illinois Department of Transportation, and 5 years with a nonprofit. Today, we're going to give you the general consensus of what it takes to be certified. The Disadvantaged Business Enterprise Program is a USDOT mandated, federally mandated program that recipients must follow in certifying minority and women-owned firms. So with that said, a roadway to opportunity awaits. Let's get started. Next slide, please. As I just stated, the DBE program is a federally mandated program. We follow the rules as stated in 49 CFR Part 26. The Illinois Department of Transportation Office of Business and Workforce Diversity is also in collaboration with the City of Chicago, CTA, PACE, and METRA in the Illinois Uniform Certification Program. This slide basically just tells you where you can look to see the history of the DBE program and the rules and regulations that we follow. If you have any questions about an application, you can also go to the website, the www.idot.illinois.gov website, and acquire an application, a personal net worth statement, a category and location form that is part of the documentation you'll need to submit. Next slide, please. DBE certification. A firm has to meet federal requirements concerning presumptive group membership or individual disadvantage, business size, personal net worth, ownership, and control. And all of that you'll find, if you're taking notes, is nothing more than what we call the four E's. The four E's being ethnicity / gender, equity, expertise, and equipment. If you can substantiate those four E's, you too can get certified. Next. So here's the first E, ethnicity / gender. Being a member of the presumed disadvantaged group of either, and I don't call them Black Americans, they're African Americans, Hispanic Americans, Native Americans, Asian Americans, Asian Pacific Americans, subcontinent Asian Americans, women of any ethnicity, or other minorities found to be disadvantaged by the Small Business Administration. Next. USDOT and SBA have determined that in regards to the DBE program, there's a personal net worth of $1.32 million. That is the cap. Doesn't matter your race, your gender, or the size of your company in regards to your personal net worth. It cannot exceed $1.32 million. It does not include your primary residence. And it does need to be reported accurately. Each firm owner whose status is being relied upon for DBE certification must submit a USDOT signed notarized personal net worth statement. As it relates to NAGS codes, as far as industry size caps relating to the size of your business, those are determined in large part by the Small Business Administration. Every firm is certified based on specific NAGS codes or categories, and SBA determines what a small business is in various categories. Let's say miscellaneous concrete, for example. It has a size cap of $19 million. And that would be averaged over 3 years. And if you, and I know that the screen says five, but it's actually 3 years, averaged over 3 years. If it's more than $19 million, then you've exceeded the size cap and you would be graduated from that program. You'd be graduated from that category. If you have other categories that are highway construction that have a size cap of $30 million, then you stay in the program. Otherwise, you've graduated from the program. If a firm's gross receipts exceed any NAGS code, they graduate from that category of work. If they don't have any categories of work that for them to be in, then they graduate from the program. The overall size category over a 3 year period is 30.4 million. So as long as you're making less than 90 million over a 3 year period, you do not graduate from the program. And that's subject to change. It changes based on inflation, both the personal net worth size as well as SBA's change of category size and USDOT's program cap size. They all change based on inflation every year, every other year. It kind of varies. Next, please. Certification with IDOT is a paper monster. IDOT does not accept things digitally, as far as your initial application. Your initial application must be signed and notarized. Your statement of personal net worth must be signed and notarized. You must submit 3 years of personal taxes, 3 years of business taxes, articles of incorporation or organization. There's a host of documentation that has to be submitted. All applicable documentation is identified on the application on page 15, which is after your notarized page. The process of certification, number one, you fill out and complete your application as best as possible. You mail that in to IDOT. We have a individual that does intake. They date stamp the application, and then they pass it to a data management specialist that inputs information into our database and then hands that off to a unit manager, a certification unit manager, who does a cursory review to determine whether or not the application is sufficient for further review. And that further review is done by a certification analyst that you will come to know. The analyst reviews your corporate structure, any trust agreements. Every document that you send in will be reviewed by that analyst. The analyst will contact you if they need additional information. They will generate a written report. They will conduct an on-site interview. And once they've done all of those things, they will submit a report to the administrative review panel that makes the decision on whether to certify, deny certify, to determine what categories of work the firm will be listed in. Next page, please. The certification review process, based on all of the documentation that you submit, the process takes about 90 days. And that's 90 days from the receipt of a complete application. And a complete application is based on if we need additional information, we'll send you a letter to acquire that information. Once we acquire it and everything is what is needed, then your 90 days begins. If your request for additional information yields more questions and we have to request further documentation, we'll send you another letter. And if it takes 20 days for that to come in, again, the 90 days doesn't begin until your application is complete. Does it normally take that long? No, it doesn't. But that is our guideline for completion of a initial application. Once your firm is certified, your firm must submit a no change affidavit on an annual basis. The no change affidavit will take you approximately 10 minutes to complete. It is a two-page affidavit. The first page has 6 lines on it to be completed. The second page has 2 lines, one of which is your signature. And it does have to be notarized. You'll receive a letter 60 days prior to your anniversary date for your no change affidavit to be submitted. If you fail to submit your no change affidavit before 30 days of your anniversary date, we will send you a second letter reminding you. If you fail to submit a no change affidavit by your anniversary date, more than likely within 2 to 3 weeks, you are going to receive a letter of proposed removal. If you fail to respond to that, you will receive a final letter removing you from the DBE program, and you will likely have to start the DBE process all over again. So we encourage you to stay up on your no change affidavit once you get certified. Next screen, please. Your certification contacts. We are located in Springfield, Illinois. Our phone number is 217-782-5490. I am the Northern Unit Certification Manager, but I also work with the South at this time. And we have 2 analysts, and where we should have 5. So please keep that in mind too when you're looking at getting certified. Mr. Dwayne Curry and Mr. Michael Hanley are 2 analysts that work diligently on no changes and on initial applications. Next. Or is that it? Now, let's go back to initial certification. If you have any questions regarding initial certification, IDOT provides consultants to assist you with completing your certification packet. The IDOT Supportive Service Programs also offer assistance to businesses once you're certified. Programs that provide management, technical, technology, and other assistance. So if you have any questions about your certification, please give us a call. We can direct you to a consultant that works free of charge to you to assist you in getting certified. Next. Questions and answers. And that concludes my presentation.
Thank you, Lincoln. Thank you for that awesome and informative presentation. And yes, it is time for the Q&A portion of this webinar. So at this time, we are happy to answer any questions. And if you do have any, please enter them in the chat box.
Well, there is one very profound question from Sergio. Can you please address the current state of the DBE program as it relates to the recent challenges and lawsuits filed against the program and to affirmative action? Well, to date, IDOT has not lost any suit that has challenged its program. That is in part because IDOT routinely employs what's called a disparity study that addresses whether or not there are actual systemic disparities that afford us to have the program that we have. We are actually in the process of one of those disparity studies now. In this line of work that I'm in, we are always mindful of firms, programs that want to gut this type of affirmative action program. So to date, yes, there's nothing, nothing to report.
Excellent. Thank you, Lincoln. I do have a few questions here that came in. Can a husband and wife get certified?
Yes. As long as the firm is owned and controlled 51% or more by a socially and economically disadvantaged individual. So yes, if a husband and wife happen to be Caucasian, yes, that firm can get certified as long as the majority, the Caucasian female, is the majority owner, has the expertise to critically evaluate, has the experience in the line of work that they're seeking certification. If she's contributed of her own resources to acquire her ownership in the firm, and the firm has the equipment to do the work, yes, theoretically, she can get certified. If they're both socially and economically disadvantaged, then yeah, that's pretty much a given.
Thank you, Lincoln. And another question here. How many categories can I get certified in?
Unfortunately, there is no limit to the number of categories that a firm could be listed under. However, again, it is based on expertise and equipment. Once we have established that you have a vested equity in the firm, and that you are socially and economically disadvantaged, categories are a matter of expertise and equipment. If you can do it all and you have all the equipment to do it all, theoretically, you can have them all. But that's rarely been the case.
Thank you again. And then we do have no questions rolling in here, and I will read the next. When you start a new company, do you need to have contracts before you can apply for DBE status?
No, you actually don't have to have contracts. Even though the program was not established for startups, we don't discriminate against startups either. As long as you have the equipment and expertise to do the work, we'll certify you in those categories. But keep in mind, it's based on documented expertise to critically evaluate work in those categories. I think Ms. Torres had a question. Is there an express application option if certified for MBE and SDVOSB with other agencies, CMS, the VA, and Cook County? No, ma'am. There is not a express application. There is no priority given. First come, first serve. If you're certified with either of those agencies, the VA or CMS, unfortunately, they don't necessarily have the same requirements as USDOT requires that we have. So there is no reciprocity that goes along with that certification that they have.
Thanks, Lincoln. Got another one here. Can you still apply for DBE status with a new business? They wouldn't have 3 years of business taxes.
Yes. Yes, you most definitely can. We do encourage you to have a projected income statement. But again, as long as you meet the four E's of equity, ethnicity, expertise, and equipment, you can certify and become certified, even with a startup having not done any business or a firm having not been in business for 3 years.
Great. Thank you. Another one here. Does being an SBA 8 certified firm require IDOT DBE certification as well?
No, it does not. And I'm not sure if the 8A program is still intact. But years and years ago, when I started this in the early 90s, the SBA 8A program was the granddaddy of all minority business programs. Right now, like with the challenges that are going on with our programs, I'm not sure if the 8A program has survived. I'm not sure that it is. But IDOT certification is not does not hinge on SBA 8A certification. Yes. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Thanks, Lincoln. Another one here. Could you please tell us how long it may take to add NAICS codes after the application has been sent?
I assume you mean after the firm has already been certified and you're simply looking to add categories. Actually, we don't have a set time that we are mandated to add those categories. We do try to do them within 60 days when we have a full staff. Currently, as I've said, our staff of 8 is down to 3. And so we're actually struggling to get category expansions done and focused on getting initial applications certified and trying to make sure that our no changes are current. So I will not give you an estimate of how long that would take to get categories added.
Thank you. And another one here, if you are not based in Illinois and are a certified DBE firm in the home states, can you be certified in Illinois?
Absolutely. Absolutely. The USDOT requires that recipients, that being IDOT being a recipient, utilize one of two methods of certifying out-of-state firms. Number one, if the firm is out-of-state, they have to be certified in their home state. Once they're certified in their home state, a recipient has a choice of A, accepting the certification of a firm based on the certificate itself and simply saying, okay, you're certified in, let us say, Iowa. Now you're certified in Illinois in the same categories. IDOT, however, does not do that. Members of the Illinois UCP do not do that. We choose B, to request that all of the information you submitted to your home state, you submit to IDOT, and we will review that and make sure that you were not erroneously certified. And then we will certify you based on the categories that you are certified in your home state, if you can qualify to provide those services in the state of Illinois. Does that make sense?
It does on this end, Mr. There's a follow-up, and maybe one that ties into the previous one. Can I be headquartered in a different state and be IDOT DBE certified?
Yes, as long as you're certified where you're headquartered at. So if you're headquartered in St. Louis, Missouri, or Milwaukee, Wisconsin, and you provide more services in Illinois than you do in your home state, you still have to be certified in your home state before we can certify you.
Great. Thank you, Lincoln. Are there any programs for small businesses that are not minority owned?
Yes. There is a, and I'm not an expert on that because my focus is always on certifying minority and women-owned businesses or socially and economically disadvantaged businesses. But I know that IDOT or the state of Illinois does have a small business initiative, what they call an SBI. And while I am not an expert in describing or informing people on where to get access to those SBIs, I do know that if you are a firm that averages less than $14 million a year, you qualify as a small business and can apply or bid on contracts for small businesses under that small business initiative.
I'm sorry, this is Siobhan Moore with the Illinois Tollway. I just wanted to kind of give some information about Mr. Blackwell with the Small Business Initiative. You do have to be registered in the state's Small Business Set Aside program in order to qualify for our Small Business Initiative registration.
Thank you, Ms. Moore.
Thank you, Siobhan, and thank you again, Lincoln. See a few more here, and we park our equipment at a yard shared lot with numerous other trucking companies, but no affiliation at all. Do we just state that on the application when it asks us about shared storage yard?
Absolutely. It is not an issue that especially trucking companies or construction companies utilize a parking of their equipment at a lot that's open to anyone and everyone that wants to pay to store their vehicles or equipment there. So no, please, by all means, just state what's going on. We want to know the truth about anything that we ask. If it asks for a parking lease, or any equipment lease, provide it. We don't have any interest in erroneously denying anyone access to this program. The more access to this program we have, the better off we are as a state, as a community. We want everybody certified that's qualified to be certified. So, yes.
Thank you, Lincoln. If you apply for the second time, does your application take the same amount of time?
Yes, sir. It's always a first come, first serve, even if you're trying to get served for the second time.
Yeah, that sounds good. And my firm is not certified in my home state, but I am 8A certified and have past performance with federal agencies. Can I apply for DBE certification?
Yes, you can, as long as you apply in your home state first.
Excellent. Thank you. Let me just confirm any other questions. I am going to ask the panelists if any questions came to them separately, just in case we see anything coming in or floating around that we may have missed. So I don't see any much more on my end. All right. Sounds good. And with that said, that will wrap up our portion of the Q&A for this webinar. And for more information on today's webinar, as well as all the programs and initiatives administered by the Tollway's Diversity Department, please visit the Doing Business section of the Tollway's homepage at illinoistollway.com. There you'll find the latest information, including a calendar of events, links to prior presentations, and view the upcoming bid letting schedule for construction and professional services contracts. Also, a little friendly reminder, the Tollway is also active on social media, anywhere from LinkedIn to YouTube and everything in between. So please check us out, smash that like button, and subscribe to our channels. Again, thank you for your time. This does conclude today's webinar. Thank you, Lincoln, for an awesome presentation and your time. That said, we appreciate everyone's support, and we look forward to you joining us for our next webinar series, which will be on the Illinois Tollways Contract Compliance Department with Goods and Services. And that is a wrap for today. Thanks again, and we will see everyone soon. Have a great day, have a great afternoon, and happy Halloween to everyone. Be safe out there.